everyone. I'm Chrys Peterson. Welcome to our Wellness Window. We are talking today about tennis elbow. And we have with us Dr. Kevin Dankert from the ProMedica Sports Medicine Institute. Dr. Dankert, tennis elbow is a little bit of a misnomer because many of us who don't play tennis can still get tennis elbow, right?
Yes, that's correct. Actually, most people who develop symptoms from tennis elbow are not tennis players. A lot of people who work in the auto industry, painters, mechanics, plumbers, hairdressers, dental hygienists, we see it all in all sorts of people.
And it has to do with what, repetitive motion in the elbow? How does it happen?
That is correct. This is an overuse injury typically caused by inflammation of the tendons that attach your forearm muscles to the outside of your elbow. So this is usually caused by repetitive activities in the wrist and elbow.
How do I know if I have it, if that's what it is?
Well, the symptoms that someone would experience are typically pain and swelling on the outside of the elbow. Some people may even experience some weakness in grip strength. But if you're unsure, you can make an appointment with your physician as this condition is typically diagnosed through a thorough medical history and examination.
So what do you do for tennis elbow? Are there things I could do at home if I'm noticing those symptoms? And then when would I know that it's time to come and see you because maybe it's a little bit more serious?
Sure, yeah. Most of these cases can be treated at home with conservative treatments. Actually, most people get better with those simple treatments. These treatments would include simple stretches, using ice or over-the-counter medications such as acetaminophen or anti-inflammatories. If those symptoms are not getting better, sometimes we will prescribe a course of formal physical therapy. And in some cases where the pain is severe or still not getting better, a steroid injection can be used to treat the symptoms.
But you can overcome tennis elbow, is what you're saying, with some of these treatments.
Yeah, the vast majority of patients will improve with very simple treatments. Some cases can become chronic. But some studies show that even after 2 years, this case or these symptoms will spontaneously resolve.
All right. Thank you, doctor. So even if you don't play tennis, you can still get tennis elbow. And as you just heard there, there are some things you can do at home to relieve those symptoms. But to make sure that it's not something more serious, you can always head to visit Dr. Dankert or one of our wonderful sports medicine doctors here at ProMedica. Dr. Dankert, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching our Wellness Window.